I had been planning a 2CT-2 experience for several days. At the last minute, a friend decided to join me for the trip. I had fasted all day and was prepared for a good experience. My friend had been up all night and did LSD the night before, and had done some 1,4-butanediol earlier, so he was in a pretty physically exhausted condition. Expecting a somewhat mild experience, I didn't think this would present a problem. The 2CT-2 came as tablets. They were obtained from the Netherlands, and were 8 mg white pills marked with what is best described as an X, with an extra leg. These seem to be the most common, if not the only, brand of commercial 2CT2. Shulgin lists the dosage range at 12 to 25 mg, so I decided to use 3 tablets for a dose of 24 mg. The setting was in my new apartment, which has now truly become home. At 10:20 p.m., we ingested our first pill. Advice from fellow entheogen enthusiasts recommended that the pills be taken at 20-minute intervals to reduce the chance of gastric distress. I decided to further reduce this risk by making a cup of ginger tea. Within 10 minutes I began to get a feeling similar to the first alert I get from MDMA class drugs. At 10:40, we took the second pill. Around 10:50, I began to feel a vague hint of nausea. My friend began dancing around the room and saying he liked it, that this seemed like a good recreational trip, and saying that it felt, sort of like ecstasy, but different. He reported that he was getting visual effects, that his vision seemed slowed down. At this point, my personal opinion was that this seemed similar to San Pedro, both in feeling and visuals, but on a smaller scale, and I expected it to continue in that direction. We were both quite mistaken. At 11 o'clock, my friend went outside to smoke a cigarette. When he came in, around 11:05, we ate the last of our pills. Sometime around 11:15, my friend reported feeling nauseous. I began to feel the same soon after. Staying still seemed to help a lot. My friend went into the bathroom, thinking he was going to vomit. He didn't, and came back a few minutes later saying he felt a little better. We sat on the couch, not really saying a lot. My friend laid down and appeared to be asleep. He was unresponsive when I spoke to him. I put on a videotape, iScape, a collection of animated abstract computer-generated art. I soon found myself tripping very, very hard. It was quite unexpected, and seemed to hit suddenly. Visually, this is spectacular. The visuals are somewhat similar though those from high-dose mescaline, but there are differences. Things move much faster. Even stationary objects appear to be moving, leaving trails. Colors are far brighter. Mentally, there was a good deal of confusion, probably caused in large part by finding myself in an unexpectedly strong and new psychedelic space, and the fact that my friend appeared to be asleep. I got up and began wandering around my apartment with no real purpose, not really able to figure out what I should be doing. I wandered into my bedroom at one point and laid down on my bed. I noticed a small spider on my wall. I was going to kill it, but was unable to do so. I went into my kitchen to get a glass and a plate to capture it. I caught it and began walking outside to release it. I watched it in the glass as I walked. I could see its anger and fear at being caught. It appeared to be trying to attack the glass it was in, flexing its body. I wondered if it were a poisonous spider, and I was somewhat afraid of it, even though it was trapped. Releasing it felt good. I tried to get a response from my friend several times, but he appeared unconscious. I looked to see that he was breathing, which was difficult to tell, since he appeared to be moving, along with everything else, then decided to go and get on an internet chatroom, since I was feeling the need for human communication. I logged into the chat room at 11:56 p.m., and explained what was going on. I was still feeling some nausea, and felt excess stomach gas similar to what I'd expect from San Pedro. I'd always thought that effect was from plant material, but I guess it may be phenethylamine related. Visual effects reached extreme proportions. Periodically, my entire visual field would be washed by waves of color, pink, green. The size of the letters on my screen would constantly shift between very tiny to gigantic. I would see complex fractal-like fields and vortexes appearing in my desk and monitor frame. Colorless, yet somehow visible, astral vines would periodically wrap around things. My floor tiles were swimming. I would see trails from stationary objects. I also experienced auditory effects. I was hearing voices constantly, which I think were conversations in adjacent apartments, and so represented sensory enhancement and not hallucinations. I was extremely confused, and the fact that my friend was unconscious didn't help to lessen that confusion. Periodically I went to check if he was responsive. Occasionally he would answer incoherently. I decided to do some GHB to mellow things out, and took 2.5 grams. This seemed to lessen the confusion, but had no other noticeable effects. The visual effects seemed to increase gradually, hitting a peak sometime around 1 a.m. At no time was there ever any real sense of panic, no real fear. Just overwhelming confusion. Confusion to the point that I felt I was going to lose my mind, but not really. At one point I said on the chat room, "I think I am freaking out. And just don't realize it," followed by, "I think this kicks ass. That or it sucks. One of the two." It didn't take me too long to decide on the former. I sat and listened to music, talked on the internet, and watched visuals for several hours. I had some rather odd physical sensations as well, such as my room seeming to be at a 45-degree angle, or the feeling that left and right had switched places. I began to develop a very strong feeling of okayness, a general feeling of well-being, but not quite to the euphoric extent I get from San Pedro or the MDMA class phenethylamines. This reminds me much more of the Dom class than anything else. I would definitely be interested in exploring other 2C series phenethylamines. Sometime around 3 a.m., I decided to smoke some cannabis, and managed to rouse my friend for this activity. He looked fairly strung out. Smoking cannabis seemed to bring him back to a communicative state, at least temporarily. After we smoked the cannabis, we decided to try and make food. He went out to smoke a cigarette, then came back in and laid back on the couch and went back to his previous unresponsive condition. I decided to make food anyway. Cooking up macaroni and cheese was pretty difficult. My sense of time was shot, and it was visually difficult to tell what I was doing. Anyway, once it was ready, I woke my friend and we ate. Eating seemed to dramatically cut down the effects of the trip. It also brought my friend back to life, though he was very out of it still. We talked for a while and eventually around 4 a.m., he walked home. I stayed tripping until 6:30 a.m., when I went to sleep. I awoke feeling somewhat tired still, and felt a little drained all day. This was an incredible experience, and one that I'm very eager to repeat. Though next time, I may try it at just 16 milligrams.